feel fantastic. I feel very healthy. I feel tired, you know, from the training, from the workload. But I know with that coming into fight week with a rest and everything else, making weight is going to be a lot easier than making welter. And I'm going to be very fueled up for the fight. I'm excited. This is the fight I've been after. If you know about boxing, you know about this fight. The attention I've been getting and everything else, you know, these are the fights what I've been saying that I wanted for a long time now, and we've got one.
Boxers often say at this point it's the hardest I've ever trained, but do you feel that because of the extra weight that you've been allowed, therefore the extra calories you're allowed to consume, that is actually true for you? It's the hardest and the most work you've ever done in a camp?
You know, I train hard for all my fights, but I think I've been able to train very hard because I've had the fuel. But I think, you know, my recovery has been a lot better because I've got the fuel. I'm getting much better sleep. But I think, you know, I've been training very 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 hard. I'm not gonna say that I've trained. This is the fight. You know, like every fight, I said this is the hardest I've trained for. You know, because I train very hard for every fight, but I think that the way I feel and recovery and everything else wise, I think that is the best I've felt, you know, in a camp.
Do you feel happier, more comfortable with the whole situation now? You're not killing yourself just to get those last few pounds off?
I do. I think, you know, I'm 30 year old. I've been making them lighter weights since I was amateur, and it is a struggle. I've put a lot of muscle on over 10, 12 years, so it is hard to make welterweight, very hard. You know, of course, I'm a happy fighter. You know, performs in the better fighter. Making these natural weights for me, you know, it's been a lot. I've been a lot more fun to be around. You know, because I'm able to eat, I'm able to train. You know, and I'm not killing myself. I'm training very hard, but in a healthy way. So I'm still killing myself in training, but, you know, like I say, I've got the fuel and the recovery to push me on.
Do you feel that making the weight for the last, like you say, 10, 12 years, do you think that could have maybe not stunted your growth, but certainly affected your development? And now that you're just allowed that extra few pounds that you've filled into it, that feels more natural anyway?
Yeah, I think so. I think I'm restricting myself from growing, you know, healthily. I'm putting restrictions on. You know, I'm burning so many calories when I'm making welterweight and I'm not having that many calories food wise, and that's the only way we can, you know, we can make the weight. You know, it is very, very hard. It is very hard, but I can still make 147. You know, wherever there's an opportunity, I'm still the welterweight champion, you know. But come September 11th, I'm gonna be the middleweight undisputed champion, you know. So I'm in a different position again. But like I said to you, he's gonna be in the big shock in his team, or when I walk out, you know, and everybody clears that ring and there's me and him in there. And we get it on. You know, he's gonna know from the first ramrod jab I choke, I mean business. You know, that he's not fighting a welter, he's fighting someone who's determined and taking them belts away from him. He's in a real fight. You know, he's in a real fight who's got no respect for him until he's got to show me something to get that respect. So that's where we are. I'm gonna go in there, kill or be killed. I'm ready to fight.
Let me ask you a bit about the Czech weight, which obviously a lot of people made a lot of, you being so much heavier than him and you supposed to be the welterweight. Can we read much into that? Is that a good sign for you?
You can read what you want into that. You know, you see me at the scale, I were on the limit, and I was, you can see me abs, I'm in great shape. You know, so it just shows and proves, you know, that I'm coming down to make middleweight. I'm coming down. And people are going to be in a big shock, you know, when we're stood inside of each other on weighing day and on fight day, you know, the size of me, you know, it's, I've not boxed at middleweight in a fight, but I know that I'm going to be, so it's going to be a natural move for me.
When these big fights happen, you often kind of look back through history a bit and people start talking about legacy and what fight does this compare to, you know, in the past. And we've talked about Sugar Ray Leonard against Marvin Hagler. Where do you think this one will rank in terms of British fighters on British soil? Do you think this could be the biggest one ever?
This fight, me win this fight, it is the best win. It's the best win any British fighter in any era has ever done. I believe it's no one comes near it. You tell me if out comes near it. They didn't do that. This is the biggest win.
Does that drive you on, that thought?
This is my sport, this is the sport. I laced my gloves on when I was 9 years old. I'm in the sport to be the best. And of course it pushes me on. I don't want to just be a world champion, an unbeaten world champion. I want to be the best in every weight category in the sport where I love boxing. I want to be the best fighter in the world, so of course it pushes me on every single day to get that win.
Do you have ideas of doing 154 as well, completing that set, that middle one as well at some point?
Yeah, I've always said that I want to be win world titles in 3 different weight categories, welter to middle. I've jumped past light middle, you know, so I want to finish the jigsaw and become world champion at light middle.
And also we just heard, just the last one, we heard that Zlatan Ibrahimovic wants to come to the fight because he's a big Golovkin fan. It's the Manchester derby on the morning of that fight, so a big day of sport. And then he's going to try and get down to London to watch the fight and cheer on GGG. Do you think you could win him over?
You know, if I win him over or I don't win him over, if he's there to see me win or to see me lose, it's still there. It's still pain to see his fight, and that, you know, that's what it's about. Everybody's got their own opinion. Everyone's got their own favourites. You know, there's going to be a lot of Golovkin fans in there. A lot of Golovkin fight. A lot of fans there for me. You know, but they're there. They're a part of a fantastic fight. You know, it's going to be an event. They're going to be part of it, and that makes me smile. You know, even if they're against me, you know, they've had a great night. So. You know, I've come to this stage in this game where, and if I were younger, I'd be like, I don't like them, and yeah. You know, but I've got nothing but smiles for them. You know, they're there, they're supporting the sport, you know, and they're there to see a fantastic fight, and they're going to see one.